If you're watching this, then you're probably juggling the demands of a 9-to-5 job while dreaming of starting your own business. In the next 10 minutes, I'll show you exactly how to balance your job while building something from scratch. It's not easy, but it's definitely possible with the right strategy and the right mindset going into it. So I'll tell you from my own experience how I was able to juggle a demanding 9-to-5 job while starting a business that's now generated over £1 million in sales. If you're new to the channel, my name's James Eardley. I run e-commerce businesses and I started those while I was busy in a 9-to-5 job, and now I was able to leave that 9-to-5 job to run my businesses full time. So I've been in that position where you are now, in a busy job, trying to work out how you can possibly find time and start a business from scratch while still working at your job. In a minute, I'll tell you exactly how I was able to start a business while working in a 9-to-5 job. But first of all, we need to cover why would you do that in the first place? So why would you start a business? Well, the reasons were clear for me when I first started. I wanted to have autonomy over my time. I wanted to be free. That was ultimate success for me. It was being away from the shackles of a 9-to-5 job. I wanted to be able to decide when I worked, where I worked, and who I worked with. And I didn't want to be told what to do, where to be, and when to do it. And that's the freedom of having a business, is that you become the boss. Nobody's going to tell you what to do, what work to do, and where to be. It's up to you what you take on. And I was craving that freedom, craving that autonomy. For so long, I was in that 9-to-5 job and I dreaded the Monday mornings. I had that feeling in the pit of my stomach on a Sunday evening that I just didn't want to go to work the next day. And I didn't want to be told what I had to do, where I had to be. I wanted to be in control of that feeling. So if you're feeling that now, I completely understand what you're going through. It's difficult and you're probably yearning for some sort of freedom and to really fulfill the potential that you've got. So for me to realize that potential, and it might be the same for you, you might be thinking about running your own business because that gives you the freedom and it allows you an unlimited potential where you can scale a business to really fulfill your potential. So the advantages of starting a business are clear, but why would you start that while still remaining in your job? Well, I think there are actually some real advantages of staying in a 9-to-5 job when you first start your business. Firstly, from an income point of view, your income doesn't slow down when you first start your business. You'll still have that income coming through, and that can either finance your new business or it can just make sure that all of your usual bills are covered and you know that that side of things are taken care of, so you can focus on your business without the stresses of having bills to pay. Making sure that your bills are covered, it will take away a lot of pressure, whereas if you were to start a business and leave your job straight away, there is that fear of making sure that you can hit the bills. And that pressure, what that often leads to is short-term decision-making. You're making decisions with a new business to make money straight away. And oftentimes, it's better to have a longer-term time horizon to make real significant returns instead of looking at how can you make money today because you need to pay the bills. So if you can, try and stay in that position where your finances are covered and that business can be on the side to start with until you're confident that your business is profiting well above what you're earning. And then at that point, I'd then cut ties with your job. But that's something that's completely up to you. You might not want to do that, but a choice you'll have to make when your business is up and running. So we've decided to start a business, but we're going to stay in our 9-to-5 job. It's now going to be a bit of a balancing act. How can we make sure that there's time for us to start a business while still remaining in a 9-to-5 job? So I'll tell you what my typical day looked like when I was starting a business. I knew that I'd start my work about 8:30. In the morning, and I had to be in the office at 8:30, and I had to leave my house at about 8 a.m. and then I used to get back at about 4:35 p.m. from my job, so not quite 9-to-5, more like 8:30 to 4:30, but I'd get home around 5 p.m. have food, and I knew I had hours in the evening as well. So a typical day, I knew that I was going to be busy from about 8 till 6 after I'd eaten, so the hours that I had potentially to find to grow a business would be before the hours of 8 a.m. and after 6 p.m. in the evening. So what I also realized is that I knew I had to have some downtime. For me, going from where I was in a busy job, I knew that it was going to be difficult to dedicate, say, 4 hours before work and 4 hours after work because I'd already be tired from my 9-to-5 job. So what I made it an absolute essential was that I would move the needle forward with one task every day, and I'd allocate myself a maximum of 3 hours in that day to get that done. I'd usually get it done in a shorter time frame than 3 hours, and that would be the real metric of success, was whether I got a task done, not necessarily the amount of hours that I spent on that day working at it. And the reason for that is because it's more important to your business that the tasks get done than the amount of time you spend on the business. So it's better to have that, I believe, as a metric of if you're being productive, is whether a task has got done that's clearly moving the needle forward instead of just time working on the business. So I knew that I could dedicate an hour, maybe an hour and a half before 8 a.m. If I got up nice and early, I'd put my alarm on at 6 a.m. and I get straight to my desk and I have one task that I'd focus on my laptop to help the business move forward. Whether that was to open up a Google Workspace account, you know, register my business initially, open a business bank account, you know, open a phone line, make sure that the real fundamentals were in place. Those were the first early tasks of growing a business. And you can do those just one task each day. And over the course of a few weeks, you'll have a fully functioning business up and running and you can start making some income. But there just needs to be one task that you focus on as the primary thing. And that's what I did for the first few weeks and actually the first few months while I was growing my business alongside my job. Now, it depends whether you're more of a morning person or a night owl. I'm certainly more of a morning person. But if you're more of a night owl, then it doesn't make a difference when you do these tasks. As long as they get done, that's the most important thing. So if you find that you work more productively after work, and perhaps you prefer to work between the hours of 9 p.m. and midnight, if that works better for you, then however that is, it's more about getting a task done. That's more important than the hours you spend and when you do it. So for me, I'd get that task done, and then I'd often use an hour towards the end of the day after food, maybe between 6 and 7 p.m. I dedicate that as well to taking a task forward on my business. And that's all it was. I didn't have to change my lifestyle dramatically to do that. I'd get up maybe an hour and a half earlier than I used to, and I'd find an hour after work to sit down and do a little bit more. But I think people get overwhelmed by the amount of work that will be involved. But if you break it right down to just one task every day that you know will move the needle forward with your business, then you can really shrink it right down and allow you to do it alongside a 9-to-5. So by finding these pockets in your day, it's amazing how much progress you can make over a substantial amount of time. The key to really having success with this and running a business alongside a job is that it is sustainable for you. And that's different for everyone. But don't go out of the blocks too soon. Don't go out too hard. And don't decide that you're going to wake up at 4:30 a.m. to work on your business for 3 hours before you then go to work. If that's not sustainable for you, don't do it. Put together a routine that works for you that you could do for 2 years. If you can't do it for 2 years because it wouldn't be sustainable for you to keep that up, then don't do it for 2 minutes. It's important that whatever routine you set up for yourself, you can continue for the long run. The best routine that you could possibly put together to run a business alongside a 9-to-5 is one that's sustainable and one that you'll continue to do over the long run. Because over the long run is when you'll make the benefits, that over the long run is when you'll get yourself set up and financially stable. And over the long run is where you're then able to choose whether you leave your job or not. You won't be able to set up a business in 2 weeks and then leave your job based on the work that you've done. So even if you had the best routine in the world and you woke up at 4 a.m. and you did 4 hours before you even started your 9-to-5 job, and then you got back and did another 4 hours, so you had a full 8-hour day every day. If you could only keep that up for 2 weeks, then that 2 weeks is completely pointless because you won't make enough traction over that time. I fully believe in the concept of 1% progress over a longer time period being much more effective than 50% progress over the course of every day for 2 weeks. I believe that won't get you anywhere because after 2 weeks, you'll be completely burnt out and you'll stop doing it altogether. And you'll just close that part of your life away and go back to your 9-to-5 job and wonder why it all went wrong. So give yourself the best possible chance. Break things down into really small, manageable chunks and just do a little bit each day over the long run. Now, what's really important with starting a business alongside a 9-to-5 job is the type of business you decide to run. I believe that the best type of business to run alongside a 9-to-5 job would be one that's completely online so that you can do it all from your laptop. If you're having demands to be in person, find customers, get out and about and try and fit that around your 9-to-5 job, you're going to have a real difficult time. Instead, if it's just a case of working on a laptop, then all you need to do is open up your laptop the first thing in the morning and you can be working within a few minutes. It's also something that's easy to pick up after work, so I go with online only. Now, the specific business model that I use and still use to this day, and it was the one that I set up alongside my job, is e-commerce and specifically selling high-ticket products. So I'm selling high-ticket physical products to customers. And the reason for that is because when you sell high-ticket products, you don't need to sell many. to generate a consistent, profitable income. And the reason I don't want to sell a lot to make the same income is because I know that I don't want to be doing lots of admin work because I had a 9-to-5 job to manage at the same time. So think about what type of business can you set up where you can reduce the amount of admin, reduce the amount of hours that's involved. And although it's going to be hard work, you know, as with every business, try and choose the business that will work around the lifestyle that you want to build. With that said, that's where my expertise lie, is with growing e-commerce businesses that are online only and enable you to leave a 9-to-5 job. If you want a head start to run one of those businesses, then I suggest looking into the description of this video and you'll find 101 profitable product ideas. And in that list, you'll find a list of products that you can sell that fit perfectly into this business model. And you'll start to understand how you can also run a profitable online business alongside a 9-to-5 job. And eventually you'll be earning significant income where you'll feel like you can leave your 9-to-5 job and run the business full time as I do now. And actually you get to a point with one of these businesses that it's almost semi-passive income because I only need to work on it a few hours per week in order to, for that income to continue to come in. I hope you enjoyed the video today. I hope it's given you something to think about. Let me know what you thought about in the comments. Drop the video a like, subscribe to the channel if you like this type of content. And what I suggest for you to watch next is a breakdown of how you can make £10,000 every month by running one of these e-commerce businesses. So click the video while it's still on screen at the moment, and I will see you in the next video.